coaches about you, and they were, you know, talking about you being a ball player, which is a pretty high compliment in the baseball world. How would you describe your style of play?
Que estaba hablando con los coaches y los coaches dicen que tú eres un pelotero, ellos dicen que es pelotero, la mentalidad de ellos es que es un pelotero bueno. ¿Cómo tú crees que te sientes, que qué clase de pelotero tú eres?
Mira, creo que no sé, yo pienso que soy un pelotero que juego duro. Me preparé mucho tiempo en las ligas menores para este momento y pienso nada más en play hard every day. Eso es lo que pienso.
Yeah, he's always been one of those guys that works really hard, and he feels like he's the type of he's one of those hard-nosed, hard-working baseball players that, you know, does whatever it takes to prepare himself to be here in the big leagues.
Feel like you're fearless on the baseball field.
¿Cómo te sientes, como no tienes miedo cuando estás allá afuera?
No. Creo que ya había trabajado mucho tiempo para llegar a este momento, y este es el momento que debería demostrar lo que ha venido trabajando.
Yeah, and now the reason he has no fear is because he's always prepared himself for this situation to be here, to be in the big leagues, to do what is necessary. So he's kind of feels like he has no fear because he's always kind of mentally and physically prepared for this moment.
Thank you, Yanni.
Thank you, Yanni.
Jeff.
Que tienes dos semanas en la Gran Liga ahorita, y ¿qué tú crees que el estilo tuyo que te ha ayudado a estar aquí siempre?
Yo pienso que ha sido la disciplina, la disciplina en el home play, la disciplina que tengo adentro y afuera del terreno. Y estas dos semanas aquí en Grandes Ligas ha sido, ¿sabes?, de aprendizaje. Cada día es un día más para aprender aquí en Grandes Ligas para ser mejor.
He's been very disciplined, not only, you know, on the field, but off the field with, you know, preparing himself for pitches and for pitchers that are, you know, he faces. But everything he's done, even in the minor leagues, is worked up to where he's at now, and that's what's really helped him right now. Cuando cerraron la temporada el año pasado, que tú no pudiste ir para la casa ahí en Venezuela, ¿verdad? No, no fuiste para atrás.
No, I live in Arizona.
Okay. So what did you do, and how did that help you get ready for this?
¿Qué hiciste cuando estabas ahí en Arizona, que te preparaste para la temporada esta?
Oh, estuve trabajando muy fuerte sobre mi físico. Siempre han dicho que, sabes, que no tengo fuerza, que no doy muchos jonrones. Trabajé mucho eso, mi velocidad nunca la descuidé. Y traté más que todo de rodearme con peloteros de Grandes Ligas, de otros equipos, y agarrar un poco de experiencia de lo que ellos decían.
Yeah, he's always been told that, you know, he's not physically fit to hit home runs and whatnot. So that's one thing that he really worked on, was kind of strengthening up a little bit. And he surrounded himself around other guys from the big leagues there in Arizona, and just kind of picked their brain and, you know, listened and got a little bit of experience more from, you know, hanging around those guys.
All right, thank you.
Thank you.
Jared?
I guess on that note, who are some of the guys who have been a big influence for you, or some guys who have helped you with the transition, whether it's here the last few weeks or just your time around the big league club?
¿Cuáles, tú sabes, jugadores o personas que te han ayudado aquí cuando has llegado a la Grandes Ligas, que te han ayudado a todas las experiencias esas?
¿De aquí del equipo?
El equipo o el otro equipo, o los amigos tuyos, no sé qué.
Desde donde yo soy en Venezuela, Eduardo Escobar, pelotero de los Braves, él me ha ayudado mucho con la parte de lo que es mental. Un buen amigo, lo que es Elvis Andrew, ha sido también parte de eso, de darme la información sobre el juego aquí en Grandes Ligas, que es un juego un poquito más rápido, que es lo mismo. Y creo que aquí me han ayudado mucho Raúl, personas que están aquí, como son los más veteranos, Brett Hall, Culberson, son personas que me han ayudado mucho cada día.
The guys he just mentioned, I'm sure you guys know some, Elvis Andrews, you know, the guys from Venezuela.
Eduardo Escobar.
Eduardo Escobar, you know, those guys have kind of talked to him, kind of given the mental aspect of the game and try to help him realize that this game's pretty fast and to kind of always keep his head up and to prepare well for games. And with our organization here, all the veterans, you know, including myself, we all kind of try to, you know, guide him in the right direction so he does the things the right way. So that's pretty much it. Everybody in this organization tries to help him out. Que en la grande liga, que cuando tú crees, porque hay mucha gente que cambia como pegan y vaina, pero tú no has cambiado nada, tú has hecho lo mismo, y ¿por qué tú crees que has estado tan bueno aquí en la grande liga ahorita?
Bueno, yo creo que no trato de cambiar nada, trato de hacer lo mismo que vengo siendo desde las menores. Aquí es el mismo juego, solo que digo que el juego es un poquito con mejor calidad. Cada quien perfecciona lo que hace, y es lo que traigo de ligas menores aquí. Quiero hacer lo mismo, jugar duro.
Yeah, he doesn't, you know, in his mental, you know, he doesn't come up here thinking he wants to hit home runs or whatever. He wants to do with the things that he's been doing down in the minor leagues. What's made him successful down there is, you know, he's trying to use that same success here. And that's where he's kind of been, that's where his head's at right now.
Thank you, Ralph.
Evan?
Stay home in Arizona.
You have a home in Arizona?
Yeah.
Okay. And then this winter you went to Colombia and played?
Yeah.
Okay. When was the last time you were in Venezuela?
2018.
2018?
Yeah.
Okay. What's that been like, Johnny, to not be home in 3 years?
The situation in Venezuela. Rujar, dile, entiendo que aquí en Estados Unidos es un poco para más trabajar mi físico y eso, y es más, se me hace más fácil aquí las cosas en Arizona, pues.
Yeah, he just feels like a lot of the things that, you know, that he's trying to do and the things he's trying to accomplish are a lot easier here in the States, and that's what he's trying to focus on right now at this time.
Yeah, visa.
¿Qué, cómo, cómo tú, qué hiciste para que te estés quedando aquí, que no tienes que ir a regresar?
Oh, tuve que ir a México a renovar mi visa.
Okay, yeah, he had to go back into Mexico to go revise his visa.
Okay, so you go back to Mexico each year to do that?
Yeah.
Okay. Have you been doing any
Sí, toda la gente en Venezuela, en tu casa, han podido verte en televisión aquí. En
Santa sí, ya. Yeah.
Your mom and dad.
My dad.
Your dad.
Yeah.
What did he say about your first couple weeks in the big leagues?
¿Qué dijo tu papá de tu primeras dos semanas aquí en la Grande Liga?
Él está muy feliz. Con mi mamá pasó algo de que mi mamá falleció 3 días después de que yo debuté. Y muy feliz porque yo sé que ella está en el cielo ahora mismo apoyándome. Un día antes de ella fallecer, ella me dijo que yo iba a ser un Grandes Ligas, y día después eso pasó.
Yeah, his dad's, you know, super proud of him, extremely happy for him. His mom passed the day before he got called up to the big leagues. So he knows that his mom's up in heaven looking down on him. And, you know, all he remembers is her telling him that he was going to make it to the big leagues one day. And he's here and he's happy.
You
I'm sorry. Your mom passed away the day before you were called up?
Yeah. My mom passed August 2.
Okay, that had to affect you. How have you dealt with that? I mean, that's got to be mucho difícil.
Dile que es una cosa que no quiero hablar, solo la mencioné, pero que algo que me motiva a mí cada día salir al terreno.
I mean, right now, Evan, he doesn't really want to talk about it, to be honest with you, but, I mean, it's just something that motivates him every day, and it's just something he has, you know, doesn't really want to talk about at this point.
Okay. All right, thank you, guys.
Thank you. Okay, we'll take one more. John?
Yeah, so you've got a couple games under your belt at leadoff in the big leagues. With your skill set, do you see that as a comfortable place for you to be, even for a whole career, leadoff hitter?
¿Y tú crees que siendo el peor de delante de todos, que tú crees que es algo que tú quieres hacer tu carrera o no?
Sí, pienso que sí. Para tener un equipo ganador, pienso que podría ayudar mucho en el primer bat del equipo.
Yeah, he thinks in his brain, he thinks that he'd be a really good leadoff batter for our organization if that's what they needed him for. And at the end of the day, he would just love to do whatever it took to help the team win.
And the first thing that Chris Woodward said to us when you first got called up, first thing he said to us is he brought up your nickname, Mosquito. Mm-hmm. How long have you had that nickname, and do you like that nickname?
¿Y cuánto tiempo tengo con él?
Con él, sí.
Ese sobrenombre, el nickname, me lo pusieron en el 2018. ¿Sabes? Me gustó porque me dijeron, ¿sabes? Significa una persona que está molestando, algo que hace daño al equipo contrario. Y eso pienso que es un buen sobrenombre.
Yeah, it started in 2018 where the guys were telling him he was like a mosquito because mosquitoes, you know, they bother people, and you know, so they think that's kind of the mentality he has when he plays the opposing teams. So he has that bothersome or you know that pesty guy or whatever. That's kind of why that name stuck with him. So, but he likes it. He's fine with it.
Okay.